Hi, in this video we will show you how to create a malicious node and simulate a sinkhole attack in NetSim. A simple MANET that runs DSR, Dynamic Source Routing Algorithm, is used as our network scenario. During this video, we will show how to set any node to be a sinkhole in MANET by a minor change in the DSR protocol source code. A sinkhole is a malicious node in MANET which gives false information that it has the shortest route to the target, thus attracting all the traffic in the MANET network to itself. The sinkhole does not forward the data to the target and instead uses the data for other malicious purposes. Let us start by creating the scenario we intend to simulate. We navigate to create a new project by clicking on Simulation, New, Advanced Wireless Networks, MANET. A grid-based environment is displayed on the screen. We add 7 nodes, node 1 through node 7 as shown. Right-click on node 1 properties and a window will appear having sections shown per the five-layer TCP/IP stack. In this, we enable a voice application going from node 1 to destination node 6. Check the routing protocol as DSR in the network layer section and enable link layer ACK. Note that MANET operates in a wireless environment and hence path loss occurs. Right click on the environment and click properties. Select channel characteristics as line of sight and set the path loss exponent relatively high, for example 3.7, so that node 1 may not directly communicate to node 6 and instead routes the packets via node 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5 to 6. Our goal is to set node 7 as the sinkhole, and let's see how to change the code to reach this goal. Create a libDSR solution in Visual Studio and include all the required files in it. In the original DSR protocol code, a packet is generated in the application layer of the source code. The packet is transmitted to transport out and then to network out, where it gets added to the send buffer of the source and an RREQ is generated. This RREQ is forwarded to neighboring nodes. The RREQ contains the target IP and also the list of IPs that the RREQ propagates through. We modify the code so that when a malicious node receives the RREQ packet, it gives a false RREP that it has a direct route from itself to the target. To do so, we create a file called malicious.c. This file has three key functions. The first is fn netsim dsr malicious node. This function returns 1 if the current device ID is the malicious node, else it returns 0. In the same file malicious.c, we have defined a macro called malicious underscore node. The device ID which is equal to this macro will be set as the malicious node. In the if statement defined in this function, we can mention the ID of the device which we wish to act as the malicious node and increase the number of malicious nodes by simply adding an OR condition. The second function is fn netsim dsr malicious root add to cache. If the device is a malicious node, this function gets executed and the route from itself to the target mentioned in the route request is added to its route cache, and thus the availability of a false shortest route from the malicious node to the target is created. The third function is fn netsim dsr malicious process source route option. In this function, if a malicious node receives a data packet, it generates an acknowledgement request to be given to the transmitter of the packet. The DSR metrics of the node is updated and the received packet is freed and not forwarded. Next, in the dsr.c file, the function fn netsim dsr run checks what type of event is occurring, for example network in or network out or a timer event. In the case of a network in event, there are various sub events like the reception of an RREQ packet, reception of a data packet, etc. In the default case where a data packet is received, if the device which receives the packet is a malicious node, we perform the function fn netsim dsr malicious process source route option that deletes the packet received. Else we perform the normal DSR function dsr process src route for the other nodes. In case of the sub-event control packet route request, if the present node is a malicious node, we perform the function fn netsim dsr malicious route add to cache, which adds the false route to its root cache. After that, the function DSR process RREQ is evaluated, which generates an RREP from the malicious node since a root has been made available in the root cache. After writing the code, compile it. Replace the new dsr.dll file in NetSim's bin directory. Now we come back to NetSim scenario and click on the simulate button, which opens a window where we enter the simulation time of 50 seconds, experiment name, and then we enable record animation and run the simulation. After the simulation is complete, click the View Packet Animation link on the left hand side. We see that an RREQ packet sent from node 4 is received by node 7, which was said to be the malicious node. This node 7 replies with a false route from itself to the target node, thus creating a false shortest path. All the data is forwarded from node 4 to node 7, which in turn does not forward it. So the path of the data packets are node 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 7. When we run the default libdsr.dll without the malicious node, we see the data flow is through the root nodes 1 to 3 to 4 to 5 and 6. Through this video, we hope you were able to see the effect of a malicious node in MANET. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.